You deserve the glory and the honor. We lift our hands in worship as we bless your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor.
You are free to open up your voice and bless the name of of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. When I was in the island, praise God. When I was in the island, we have a saying, praise God. Don't wait until someone catch on fire. Make your own fire. Praise God. You don't have to wait until someone else catch on fire for you to feel their fire. Praise God. But when we all get together, praise God, and we make our own fire, praise God, then the fire will definitely be hotter. Praise God. When you experience God for yourself, praise God, then you don't have to rely on someone else's experience. You don't have to rely on someone else's praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. I'm going to read the scripture this morning. Hallelujah. It's taken from Nahum chapter 1. Nahum chapter 1. Hallelujah. Amen. Nahum chapter 1. We will be reading from verse 1 until the ending. My God. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I feel God's presence in this place this morning. Hallelujah. Amen. I once heard someone said, when His presence show up, praise God, then you forget all about what is happening around you and just focus on God. When His presence show up, praise God, it doesn't matter about what happened during the week. But when His presence show up, praise God, then you lift your hands, then you bow down your head, and then you worship God. Praise Jesus. When His presence show up, what kind of worship would you give Him when His presence show up? Hallelujah. 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 When His presence show up, what kind of worship will you give Him this morning? Hallelujah. How will you express yourself to your God? Hallelujah. Jesus. When His presence show up, what will you say to Him this morning? Hallelujah. His presence is surely in this place this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. His presence is here. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You don't have to be pumped to worship God. Just think about the goodness of Jesus. Hallelujah. All that He has done for you. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, when His presence show up, what will you do? Hallelujah. Chapter 1. Nahum chapter 1. Jesus. Nahum chapter 1. And it reads us, the burden of Nineveh, the book of the vision of Nahum the Elkoshite. God is jealous, and the Lord revenged. The Lord revengeth and is furious. The Lord will take vengeance on his adversaries, and he reserveth wrath for his enemies. The Lord is slow to anger and great in power, and will not at all acquit the wicked. The Lord has his way in the whirlwind and in the storm, and the clouds are the dust of his feet. He rebuketh the sea and maketh it dry, and dryeth up all the rivers. Bashan and languisheth, and Carmel and the floor of Lebanon languisheth. The mountains quake at him, the hills melt, and the earth is burnt at his presence. Yea, the world and all that dwell therein. Who can stand before his indignation? And who can abide in the fierceness of his anger? His fury is poured out like fire, and the rocks are thrown down by him. The Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble, and he knoweth them that trust in him. I'll read that again. The Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble, and he knoweth them that trust in him. But with an overrunning flood, he will make an utter end of the place thereof, and darkness shall pursue his enemies. What do he imagine against the Lord? He will make an utter end. Affliction shall not rise up the second time. For while they be folded together as thorns, while they are drunken as drunkards, they shall be devoured as stubble fully dry. There is one come out of thee that imagineth evil against the Lord, a wicked counselor. Thus saith the Lord, though they be quiet, and likewise many, yet thus shall they be cut down. When he shall pass through, though I have afflicted thee, I will afflict thee no more. For now will I break his yoke from off thee, and will burst thy bonds in asunder. And the Lord had given a commandment concerning thee, that no more of thy name be sown. Out of the house of thy gods will I cut off the graven image and the molten image. I will make thy grave, for thou art vile. 15 and last. Behold, upon the mountains, the feet of him that bringeth good tidings and publisheth peace. O Judah, keep thy solemn feast, perform thy vows, for the wicked shall no more pass through thee. He is utterly cut off. This is the word of the Lord. God bless you all in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's continue to worship the Lord in his house. He is worthy of all praise. Come on, extend your voices this morning and give him all praise. It belongs to him. Thank you. Making Praise team, I would just like to welcome all of God's children into the house of the Lord this morning. Praise God, all our members and our guests alike this morning. Praise God, I would like to welcome you to Faith Apostolic Ministries. Amen. Give yourselves a hand for being here this morning. You have chosen the best place to be in the entire world this morning. Praise God. And you are so special to us. Amen. Praise God. We have no first-time visitors. Is there a second-time visitor? Is this your second time here? Just want to wave your hand so we can welcome you again. If not, we just welcome you all on the behalf of our pastor, Lady Ray, in her absence. We just want to welcome you. Feel free to worship the Lord this morning. Give it all to Jesus. Give everything that you have. Lay everything aside. Lay all the weights that easily beset us. And let us run this race this morning. Let us worship God like this is our last chance and our last day in the land of the living. Worship the Lord this morning in the beauty of holiness. Amen. Praise God. And as customary, praise God, we just want to go around this morning, love on each other, give big kisses and hugs to our neighbors and our friends in Jesus' name. Praise God. Praise team.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, I want to see him just to look upon his face.
Oh,
complacent, knowing that we come back here every Sunday and we worship every Sunday and we'll pray every Sunday. What if this was it? What if this service? What if this? choice. We can choose to come and leave the same, or we can choose to come and say yes and be changed. We can choose to come and say yes and be transformed. So today we come with a choice, and it's good to see you here. It's good to see you here, but even better than seeing you here is seeing you here. Amen. Is seeing you here. Amen. Amen. Let the Lord work on you today. Let him work on you today. Amen. Amen. We have today, after service, we will be celebrating with the Landell family their baby shower. Today, after service, at 4 o'clock. They are registered at Amazon, Target, and Walmart. Saints, you are too late for that two-day shipping Amazon has. So for you, they're registered at Target and Walmart. Amen. Coming up on the 14th, we will be having our children's Christmas party here on Friday night at 6:30, children's Christmas party. This is all youth ignite, and children will be coming here on Friday night. We will be having talent show. We will be having exchange of gifts. I know so many of the young people have signed up. So many of the young people have signed up to share their talents with us, and we're so excited to see. We'll be sharing the story of Christmas. Amen. If you have drawn a name and you have signed up to bring a gift, please do so as soon as possible. Don't let that child be the one with empty hands on Friday night, right? Bring your gift. You can bring it today. You can bring it during the week at some point. You can bring it on Friday night. But please, as soon as possible, bring those gifts. Bring those gifts in. Amen. On December 15th, that is on Saturday, from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m., there will be a meeting here at church for all leaders of the ministry. All leaders or people who would like to be leaders, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. on Saturday, a meeting here at the church. On December 22nd, there will be ladies' prayer here at 7 a.m. That's December 22nd, ladies' prayer, 7 a.m. here. December 31st, we'll be having our watch night service. It will begin at 10 p.m. Watch night service begins at 10 p.m. Amen. Looking into the new year, we are very excited to be attending the Purity Conference. The Purity Conference will be February 20th to 23rd. It is being hosted by Victory Family Worship, Pastor Nyarko's church. That's February 20th to 23rd. The cost for people 12 and up is $175. Ages 5 to 11 coming with their parents is $125. I would encourage every young person in this ministry to attend. Every young person to attend. Amen. This is a conference that really covers the issues that our young people face, that really covers the pressures that our young people face in school every single day. Amen. They've put together an amazing panel of people, panels of professionals, to come and talk to our young people about these issues, to really talk to our young people from a professional Christian perspective about the questions that they might have about themselves, about the people around them, about the situations that they face. Amen. So it is a three-day conference. And I really encourage every young person in the church, every young person in the church to attend. Amen? If you are not a young person and would like to attend, please come. If you're not a young person but you would like to sponsor a young person to attend, please speak with me or Sister Angelina after the service and we can arrange that. Amen? Amen. We also have coming up, by next Sunday, we should have the final price for you of the Uganda mission trip. The Uganda mission trip is coming up from April to May this coming year. Amen. All of you have already given your names to Pastor if you're interested in attending. So next week, we should have the payment information, payment plan information ready for you. Amen.
coming up this week. On Tuesday evening, there will be prayer here at 7 o'clock. Wednesday evening, level 2 discipleship will be meeting at Sister Carrie's home at 6:30. There is no more level 1 discipleship. You guys finished, so pause. Amen. If you are interested in joining discipleship, please speak with me. We're going to have a new class starting in the new year. So please, if you're interested in joining a discipleship class, please speak with me and we'll get you into that class that starts in January. Amen. On Thursday evening, we will be having Bible study here at 7 o'clock. And then on Friday, we will have our youth Christmas program. Amen. Have a blessed day.
Well, praise God. Shall we praise the Lord, everybody? Amen. Our God is a good God, isn't he? In him we live. I'm in the house, but not in the monitors. In him we live, in him we move, and in him we have our being. Is that amen, everybody? Amen. Praise God. We serve a mighty God. Amen. It is so good to be here. Amen. Again, worshiping the Lord with you all. Amen. God is so good, isn't he? Praise God. Anybody in love with Jesus? Anybody in the house in love with Jesus? Praise God. Our God is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. As the ushers are making their way, we want to remind everyone, amen, that next week, as Sister Inga said, for those of you that will be going to the Uganda trip, amen, we'll be having all that information for you. The travel agency is working on that currently, and by this week they will give us all the information we need in the sense of price and what is required of us for the missions trip. Amen. Praise God. Amen. So we ask everyone, to those of you, I know we have quite a few folks who have signed up for this, so please, after service on next week, we'll also meet with those individuals. So those of you that desire to go, very important that you're here next week so that we can meet with you and give you more information. Is that amen, everybody? Amen. Praise God. I want to say thanks to everyone here and your love and your expression to my wife and I and the arrival of our newborn son, and to Jehu. We thank God for him, Jehu Joshua Ray. Amen. Just a blessing in our family, and we thank God for him. I greet my sweet wife that's watching at this time. Amen. And as much as I'm here, my heart is there. Praise God. Amen. But I thank God for her, and pray the Lord's hand just be with her while she is there. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Just see with me a little bit. I'm a bit heavy with a message in my spirit here this morning. But we pray the Lord will speak what he wants to say. All right, praise God. Let us all stand everywhere. I feel like I'm in a theater. Amen. Let us all stand everywhere. Amen. As we prepare to give unto the Lord what is due unto him. Oh, praise the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I heard you all singing the song earlier. Amen. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
release in this house. Some of you trying to quench the Holy Ghost here. Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. And so, God, we thank you for the gift and the giver. We thank you for your people. Prison doors.
Hallelujah.
You shall loose the bands of wickedness.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Your name will be glorified.
Jesus.
I pray that you will speak to our heart.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
As you prepare to give unto your work.
Yes, Lord.
Bless your people in abundance.
Hallelujah.
Open doors, supply needs.
Yes.
God, as they obey your word and your bidding in paying of our tithe and giving of our offering, as we bring our tithe and our offering to you, O God. And Lord, that which you are speaking into our spirit in this moment to give as an offering, God, I pray you'll help us to be obedient to the prompting of the Lord and obey when you speak. And we thank you for what you will do. In Jesus' name, somebody say amen.
Amen.
And the church say amen.
Amen.
Praise God. In this mode of worship, just continue to come worshiping the Lord, following the direction of the ushers as we come on down to give unto Almighty God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Just follow the direction of the ushers. Ushers, you can start leading the folks. Amen. As we continue to give, just lift your hands and worship, everybody. Hallelujah. He is Lord. He is Lord. He has risen from. Every tongue. Somebody say amen. Amen. Praise God. I want to thank God. It's good that Sister Sophia is back with us safely. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. And it's good to see Sister Amy. God bless you, sweetheart, and her friends that are here. Amen. We greet you all in Jesus' name. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
God is good, isn't he?
Yes, all the time.
We serve Almighty God. Good to see you, Sister Dawn. God bless you.
Amen, amen.
Amen. So praise God to see you alive. But it's good that you're in the house of the Lord today.
Yes.
And in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy.
Yes.
And at his right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Someone separate these two voices, please. Amen. There are pleasures. Josiah, don't sit beside your grandmother. There are pleasures forevermore. Amen. Praise his wonderful name. Praise God. Amen. God is good, isn't he?
Yeah.
Praise Jesus. I want to minister to you from a portion of scripture that I been carrying for some weeks now during the time of being in the hospital and so on. I was telling my wife, it's amazing the places God will speak to you. Amen. Five messages were birthed in my spirit in the hospital. Five messages. And we'll see what the Lord will do. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
But God is good. It's good to be back. Good to see you all. Amen. Praise the Lord. If we could all stand to Genesis and turn to Genesis chapter 3. Genesis, the third chapter. Book of the beginning. Genesis, the third chapter. Oh, praise his name. Genesis chapter 3. Young men who are not yet married, pray that the Lord give you the right one.
Amen.
Dear Jesus, when you find the right one, life don't feel right without them near you. Amen. God is good. Genesis chapter 3, and we'll be looking from verses 1 through to 6. The Bible says, now the serpent, everybody say the serpent.
The serpent.
The serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. The serpent was more subtle. Subtle serpent. Which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, woman being Eve, yea, hath God said, he shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God hath said, he shall not eat of it, neither shall he touch it, lest he die. I want to read verse 3 again. But of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God hath said, he shall not eat of it, neither shall he touch it, lest he die. And the serpent, the subtle serpent, said unto the woman, he shall not surely die. For God doth know that in the day he eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. And when the woman saw, everybody say she saw.
She saw.
And the woman saw that the tree was good for food and that it was pleasant to the eyes and a tree to be desired to make one wise. She took of the fruit thereof and did eat and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat. Father, we thank you for your anointing and your presence that is here. Lord, you have spoken this word into my spirit and you have confirmed this word. And I pray, O Lord, that you will anoint this lump of clay one more time. Hide me, O God, remove every hindrance, anything that would block the move of your spirit. Touch my ears, my mind, my speech. God, let me speak and do as you would have me to. And God, I will give you the praise, the glory, and the honor. Somebody say, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. And you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I want to speak to you this morning on this theme, the subtlety of the serpent. The subtlety of the serpent. The subtlety of the serpent. There was a woman back in 1967. I'm getting some feedback here. There was a woman back in 1967 by the name of Carol Fosse who wrote, amen, something by the name called Satan's Evil Plan. Satan's Evil Plan. And when I saw this, I said, I'm going to take my time and read this morning. She wrote, Satan called a worldwide convention of demons. In his opening address, he said, we can't keep Christians from going to church. We can't keep them from reading their Bibles and knowing the truth. We can't even keep them from forming an intimate relationship with their Savior. The devils realize that they can't do that. Because a child of God who determines to go up to God will find God. Are you with me, somebody? Let me just pause enough to say that the devil can't keep you from God. Did you hear what I said? Everybody's drawn away by what?
His own lust
and his entice.
Right.
Are you with me, somebody?
Amen.
So if I choose to do outside of the will of God, it is that I have yielded myself to the instructions of the devil.
Wow.
Are you with me, somebody?
Amen.
It goes on to say, once they gain their connection with Jesus, our power over them is broken. So let them go to their churches. Let them have, amen, their time together. Let them worship. Let them have their communion. Let them do all of this. But this is what we will do. We will steal their time. So they don't have time enough to develop a real relationship with Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
This is what I want you to do, said the devil. Distract them from gaining hold of their Savior and maintaining that vital connection throughout their day. How shall we do this? His demon shouted. Satan said, keep them busy in the non-essentials of life.
Wow.
And invent innumerable schemes to occupy their minds. Tempt them to spend, and borrow. Persuade the wives to go to work for long hours and the husbands to work 6 to 7 days each week, 10 to 12 hours a day, so they can afford their empty lifestyles. Let them work and buy all they can. Keep them busy working so they can afford that empty lifestyle. Jesus. Keep them from spending time with their children. As their families fragment, soon their homes will offer no escape from the pressures of work.
Jesus.
You will leave the busyness of this life and go home to pressure.
Wow.
Because Satan has crept in and have messed up your tranquil place.
Jesus.
Called your home.
Jesus.
Overstimulate their minds so that they cannot hear that still small voice.
My God.
Fill them with the worries of this world so that they can't hear God. Entice them to play the radio, their CDs, whenever they drive. Keep them to keep the TV, the PCs going constantly in their home, and to see to it that every store and restaurant in the world plays non-biblical music constantly. This will jam their minds and break that union with Christ. And let me just pause and pray this. Satan will have you at times. I know what I'm saying here. He will have you at times listen to a lot of messages and a lot of singing, but really trying to use that as a substitute for your relationship with God.
Wow.
I listen to a lot of music, but I won't pray.
Jesus.
I let them teach me, but I won't apply what I'm learning.
Lord.
Fill the coffee tables with magazines and newspapers. Pound their minds with the news 24 hours a day. Let them get so caught up in politics
right.
that they miss me. Because let me tell you, I don't mean to cause any trouble for anybody, but let me tell you this. It doesn't matter what side, whether left or right, not one is saved.
Right. Come on.
So what's the enemy's plan? To fill you with the media, to fill you with news until it gets into your spirit that you begin to be led by the media and not know it.
My God.
Your thought patterns are being led by the media and not by the word.
Jesus.
The subtlety of the serpent.
Oh God.
Invade their driving moments with billboards. Let them no longer pray while driving.
Wow.
Flood their mailboxes with junk mail, mail order catalogs, sweepstakes, and every kind of newsletter and promotional offering, free product, service, and false hopes. And sometimes we get caught onto it because it sounds cheap, but really we don't need it.
Jesus.
I know I wasn't going to get a lot of amens this morning. But I'm going to say as the Holy Ghost put it on my heart.
Amen. Preach.
Fill you with a lot of things to let you think that you need it, but really you don't.
My God.
And Satan entices you to bring more stuff in your home to take up your time. So now you need a triple play. You can't live without a triple play. Keep skinny, beautiful models on the magazines and TV so their husbands will believe that outward beauty is what's important. And they'll become dissatisfied with their own wives. Keep the wives too tired to love their husbands, to take care of their sexual needs. Give them headaches too. If they don't give their husbands the love they need, they'll begin to look elsewhere. That will fragment their families quickly. Give them Santa Claus to distract them from teaching their children the immaculate birth of Jesus Christ. Give them Easter bunny so they won't talk about his resurrection and power over sin and death. Amen. Even in their recreation, let them be excessive.
Wow.
Have them return home from their recreation exhausted. Because it's God's will for you to rest.
Jesus.
And even that, the enemy is going after.
Jesus.
Because when you're exhausted, you become so overwhelmed.
Yes.
You can't function right. Keep them too busy to go out in nature and reflect on God's creation.
Wow.
When was the last time you went out and said, what an awesome God? Send them to amusement parks and sporting events, plays, concerts, and movies instead of enjoying God's creation. Keep them busy, busy, busy. And when they meet for spiritual fellowship, involve them in gossip and small talk so that they leave with troubled consciences.
My God, my God.
Couldn't get anything out of the service.
Jesus.
Because Satan ensured that he filled your ears with issues in the body.
Jesus.
So that you leave without a blessing.
My God.
Crowd their lives with so many good causes that they have no time to see the power of Jesus.
Wow. Wow.
Soon they will be working in their own strength, sacrificing their own health and family for the good cause. Because the good cause now override knowing Jesus. Because we're doing good things. The devil said, it will work. It will work. It was quite a plan. The demons were eagerly to their assignments, causing Christians everywhere to get busier and more rushed, going here and there, having little time for their God or their families, having no time to tell others about the power of Jesus to change their lives.
Jesus.
I guess the question is, has the devil been successful in his schemes?
Father.
You and I, let's be the judge of that. These are things we need to ask ourselves. Has the devil came into my home and my life, and has he caused me to feel as if I'm okay, but in reality, I'm far from God? What does subtle mean? It means hard to grasp, not obvious or easily understood. Not noticeable, cleverly contrived, cunning, skillful. And this is the accuser of the brethren, a subtle serpent, a subtle devil. And he comes, and when he comes, he makes you comfortable. When he comes, he makes you feel that everything is all right. But the way he does this, by starting off in giving you some truth.
Jesus.
And then he goes off on a tangent with falsehood. That's why it is so important for every one of us as believers that we know the word. Oh, hallelujah. That we are grounded in the truth, that we be not deceived in this last hour. It's a subtle devil. Hallelujah. It's a subtle enemy. This enemy will make you come to church but hate your brother.
Wow. Lord.
This subtle spirit will let you be involved in ministry and your spirit not right.
Jesus.
This subtle spirit will let you do wrong and justify the wrong.
Jesus.
This subtle spirit Somebody say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. It's a subtle spirit. It's a spirit that will let you go to bed without praying. But because you felt God on Sunday, you feel you're all right.
My God, my God.
It's a spirit that will let you live to see Sundays come around. So that you can feel what you like to feel.
My God.
But keep you dry and empty all week. It's a spirit that will let you live on the corporate wind of God without having a personal wind in your life. It is a spirit that even when God is whispering in your ears that this what you're doing is wrong, you'll still do it.
My God.
And still do it. It's a subtle spirit. You know you need to say sorry to your spouse. But pride has you hostage from saying sorry.
Jesus.
It's a subtle spirit. And you just think it's a simple misunderstanding. But what you don't know, Satan has entered into a door that you opened.
My God.
Because Satan cannot open any doors in your house. You've got to give that devil access. Did you hear what I said? When you watch things that you ought not to watch, you have opened the door.
Right.
When you say things you ought not to say, you have opened the door.
Right.
When you do things you ought not to do, you have opened a door.
Lord, have mercy.
Oh, he'll try to come in, saints. But the believer has got to give him access. Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yeah. Amen.
And I'm talking in a saved home. Come on. Hallelujah. And let me, Holy Ghost, just fix me there a minute there. And let me just say, even in a home where somebody there might not be saved, you are the watchman. Talk to me, somebody. Come on, saints. You're the watchman on the wall, guarding your children, guarding your life. For this unclean spirit, he is subtle. And he wiggles his way into any open space. It is a spirit, hallelujah, that will cause you to deny some truths and hold to some. Well, I believe this, but I don't know about this. It's a spirit that will let you talk against truth to satisfy your fleshly desires.
Jesus.
Everybody say a subtle spirit.
A subtle spirit.
Eve, when the serpent saw her, Eve was in the garden that God created. God created this beautiful place for Eve. It was ready. It was set up for her. Eve, I'm putting you here, Adam. I'm putting you here, Eve. She came into something already prepared.
My God.
And so are you and I. We were born. When you came into the kingdom, God brought you in here in something already prepared and planned out.
Yes.
It was a mistake. He planned this out. You came into this thing. Amen. Already planned out. And God has your future already outlined.
Yes.
But an unclean spirit came in and said to Eve, Eve, oh Eve, what does the scripture say here? It says, yea, hath God said, he shall not eat of every tree of the garden. Have
God said that, yes, Satan. Yes, he did. Go to Genesis chapter 2. Verse 15 to 17. Put it up for me, Sasha. Genesis chapter 2, verses 15 to 17. And the Lord God took the man and put him in the garden to dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, but of the tree of knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it, for in the day that thou eatest thereof thou shalt surely die. We need to go back to say, devil, yes, he told me so. Yes, he said, this tree I ought not to touch. Yes, this tree I ought not to eat from and stand on it and rebuke the devil. Somebody right now say, Satan,
Satan,
the Lord rebuke thee.
The Lord rebuke thee.
Yeah. After you have said what is written, you need to rebuke that unclean spirit that is trying to sow evil within your spirit.
My God.
Not only should you say no, but you need to rebuke that unclean spirit.
Jesus.
The woman said, this is the problem she made. Yea, hath God said, he shall not eat of the tree. The serpent said, and the woman said unto woman, we may not eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God had said, he shall not eat of it, neither shall thou touch it, lest he die. That's where the conversation should end.
Yes.
Talk to me, somebody. Yes, that's where the conversation must end in our walk with God. When temptation comes, we must speak the word and rebuke the enemy. End the conversation, because this enemy is subtle. And he's looking for a weak spot to enter. The order of God is that God placed the man to name the animals. He was a man of authority. So what did the enemy do? He tried to find some weak link somewhere. Talk to me, somebody. He stepped over the order of God and went to the man's wife. Talk to me, somebody. Let me just encourage a woman of God here. You are married to a saved man and you know he's saved. If he is giving you an instruction that's right according to the word, yield and submit to a godly man in your life. Is anybody hearing me here? Because I've got to take a stand against this feminist movement. I know I'm getting in trouble, but that's all right. I'm in the order of God's word. I've got to take a stand against it in the name of Jesus. That spirit that does not want you to be in submission.
My God.
It's a solid spirit.
Jesus.
Because the order of God is, let God be true this morning, every man a liar.
Yes.
The order of God is, the head of every man is God.
Yes.
The head of every woman is the man. There's a spirit that is sweeping our country,
yes,
sweeping our nation, sweeping our world, that lets you feel that you don't need to submit. But it's an unclean spirit. God made you to be a helpmeet. God made you to be beautiful the way he made you. God made you to be calm. God made you to be meek. The holy woman of old.
Yes, come on.
Almighty. The holy woman of old would submit to their husbands.
Yes.
The holy woman of old would dress right.
Yes, yes.
The holy woman of old would carry themselves right.
Yes.
And say, I'm a daughter. I'm not trying to be a man, I'm a daughter. I've been created to be a daughter. And I'm proud of who I am as a daughter in the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Every lady here, lift your hand and say, I'm a daughter of the King. I'm not trying to change my gender. I'm not trying to change my role. I know my role.
Yes, hallelujah.
I'm a daughter. Talk to me, somebody. I'm a daughter. And daughters are taken care of by their fathers.
My God.
Talk to me, somebody. Daughters follow the instructions of their father. I refuse to allow a son of spirit to take me under the covering of my father.
Hallelujah.
I told you, pray for me. I'm carrying a heavy word here this
morning.
Pray for me. I'm going to be a daughter. Sister Kamika, be a daughter. Hallelujah. Stand, sister. Be a daughter. And be proud of it. Let nobody tell you what is beauty. Because this book already told you. And tell that subtle spirit, you will not tell me what's beauty. Yeah. I'm born again. I am a Jesus. I feel the Holy Ghost. Come here, sister, stand here. All of you, stand here. All of you. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Women of God, made in His image, made in His likeness. That subtle spirit, we wage war against you in this assembly. We wage war against you in this house. We wage war against you in this house. We are apostolic.
Hallelujah,
Lord. Hallelujah. Tell our boys.
Oh God.
Love the word.
Yes,
that generation.
Oh God.
Tell them, I know it's tough, but tell them,
oh,
young people must be an example of the believers.
Oh Lord.
Tell them, that's what the book said. I know it's hard being an example, but God said that's who you are. You are an example of the believers in word, in charity, in conversation, in purity, in faith.
Yes, Jesus.
Saints, don't let the enemy make you come to church and don't connect with God. Don't let the devil let you stand in a place that we have consecrated for the Lord and have you on your phones. Don't let the devil do that to you.
Yes.
The subtle spirit, what he's trying to do is make you busy and clock you out and cut you off from what God is trying to deposit in your spirit.
My God, my God.
Tell the devil, I'm not missing what God has for me.
Yes,
I'm not missing it. I need every piece of it. Yes. I need everything that God wants to give me. I refuse to let a subtle spirit.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Those that carry the true anointing of God.
My God.
There is a separation of these people.
My God. My God.
Those that walk in the true glory of God.
My God.
There is a difference about these people.
Jesus, Jesus.
You don't run down what you're not ready for yet.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
A subtle spirit will let you feel like waiting is not good.
Jesus, Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus. This book says, wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. He shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord.
Oh. I.
Shall be like Mount Sion that shall not be removed but abideth forever.
Oh, Jesus.
Waiting is God appointed. Waiting is God assigned. It's the divine will of God for his children to wait on him. Do not curse your waiting period. Do not curse waiting on the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Paul said, church, the devil is a charmer. He is a charmer. 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 2 to 3. Paul says, for I am jealous over you, Corinthians, with godly jealousy. For I have espoused to you one husband. I've given you one husband. That I may present you as a chaste virgin to Christ. But I fear, lest by any means, as the serpent beguiled Eve through his subtlety, so your minds should be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ. I'm afraid. I'm afraid, said the apostle, that by any means that serpent that beguiled Eve through his subtlety, that your mind should be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ Jesus. I'm afraid, I fear, the Apostle Paul says, that this world gets to you so much, that this enemy beguiles you so much, that the sweetness of his word becomes bitter to you.
My God.
That the things you used to love and hold dear, you no longer hold dear. The things you used to walk away from, you no longer walk away from it. The things you used to allow the Holy Ghost to guard you from, you have opened up yourself to be an attack. I fear. Faith Apostolic Ministries, in the name of Jesus, let us stay.
Yes, yes.
Let us stay.
Yes, Lord.
Under the banner of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, stay in him. A subtle spirit. This spirit will pull humility from you. Oh yeah. The spirit will take humility from you. Oh yes, it will. Don't let it take that away from you. Don't let this spirit pull that out of you. This spirit, I said earlier in the writing, that this spirit will let you receive something from church. And by the time you're walking out the door, someone has something to tell you that snatches it from you. Don't let the enemy snatch from you. Oh yes, thank you, Lord. The Holy Ghost just said something to me. He says one of his subtlety is that the man of God that you know is speaking from God, the first thing the enemy will do is give you a bad image of your man of God. So that you cannot receive when God speaks to you. It's a spirit.
Yes.
The spirit.
Yes.
It will put things in your spirit and in your mind against people that you know have the word of God for you.
Yes.
And what this subtle spirit does, he wants to cut off every good company from you.
Right.
So you no longer hear wisdom. For in the counsel of many, in the company of many, there is safety. So what the enemy do is isolate you so that your safety net is pulled from you. How you know you're drifting is when you drift away from spiritual people. Satan is trying to pull away your safety net. Be careful when the people that you know are of God has become your enemy. Be careful when the people when you were spiritual, you knew that they were not godly, have now become your friends. You hearing me, somebody?
Yes.
It's a subtle spirit.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Don't let me be like Demas.
Yes, come on. Yes, Lord.
Demas is the thing that walked with the Apostle Paul.
Yes.
But his love for this world caused him to walk away from godly friendship. Don't let us be
like Rehoboam. But let's not be like Rehoboam. The kingdom was given to him. His father left him with godly men, a company of counselors. But instead he pushed them away and took to himself young people who knows nothing and seek their counsel from that instead of spiritual people. And the Bible says he destroyed the children of Israel and God took the kingdom from him. Be careful. Be careful if your counsel is from unsaved people. Talk to me somebody. Be careful that you are not drawn away by the riches of this world and the desires for wealth. It will pull your anointing. Oh God Almighty. Your commitment to church will diminish because of your love for money. For the love of money is the root of all evil. Gain all you can. Oh yes. Pursue your dreams. Oh yes. But ensure that it does not take you away from the house of God. You need to stay in the house of bread where you can be fed. I'm going to close this message here now. 2 Corinthians chapter 11. Put it up on the NLT for me, Sister Sasha. 2 Corinthians chapter 11. And from the 12th verse to the 15th verse. 2 Corinthians chapter 11. From the 12th to 15th verse in the NLT. It says, but this is the Apostle Paul speaking. He said, I will continue doing what I have always done. This will undercut those who are looking for an opportunity to boast that their work is just like ours. These people are false apostles. They are deceitful workers who disguise themselves as apostles of Christ. But I am not surprised. Even Satan disguises himself as an angel of light. Verse 15. So it is no wonder that his servants also disguise themselves as servants of righteousness. In the end, they will get the punishment for their wicked deeds deserved. I close on this here today. This sort of spirit has agents that he works through. And they are new day preachers. The emergent church. Are you hearing me, somebody? Hallelujah. Satan will appear as truth so that he might lead you astray. Don't expect to see him with warning signs that say beware. Don't you expect to see that. Because Satan will come as an angel of light. So there won't be a warning sign saying, look out, look out, look out. What causes you to see it is if you're in the spirit. Is if you are fed on the word of God. You're able to pick up when an unclean spirit is being portrayed. Are you hearing me, somebody? The spirit that is flaunting itself. Be careful. Saints of God, let me warn you. You can pick up spirits by the things you watch. When I was growing up, you know, we didn't have all this TV and TV preaching. You know what we used to do? We used to pray. Talk to me, somebody. And it wasn't only the preachers who were anointed. The saints were also anointed. But today, the saints are not anointed. They look to the preachers. So we're no longer praying. We look to you to crank us up on a Sunday. we are looking to men, we will be deceived. Because those of us who are called of God and anointed of God, the Bible says signs will follow us. We don't have to follow after signs. Many believers today are being deceived by signs. Oh, Apostle Paul says that no wonder. I am not surprised that these messengers, these apostles, they operate as angels of light. But the Bible said, be sober. Be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, walketh about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, be very aware. Be aware. Oh, saints, you don't know how much this message challenged my life. Be very aware when my prayer life goes down. Something came in. A subtle serpent. Say, you've got to live this way, saints. The things you used to do when you were with God, walking with God. And when that level in God dwindles, don't look around, look within. What is it I've stopped doing? What is it I've ceased from that I've caused this serpent called the devil to walk in and have overtaken me? Be careful. Somebody shout, be careful. I'm going to show you what birthed this message. We were in the vision, it seemed like it was our building. And it was the end of a service. And as we were leaving, it was me and another sister. I can't pick out who it was. And we were getting ready to close up church, had a great service. And we were closing up church. We were closing up the church doors. The sister was inside. I was about to step out. And as I was about to step out, I saw demons marching towards the building in order to take over. And I stepped out, I pushed the sister back, and I stepped out and I locked the door behind me. And I remember I kept saying, the blood of Jesus is against you. And as I said, it's as if it would barely hit them. It's as if it barely hit them. And I heard in my spirit in the dream, the voice said, rebuke them. He said, rebuke them. Then I said, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. And immediately they began to dissolve until they disappeared. And the Holy Ghost began to show me something. He said, when you approach a devil, you rebuke him in my name. The blood is to cover you from sin. The blood is to protect you from the second death. But the devil, we must rebuke them in the name of Jesus. I grew up on the scene. People say, the blood is against you. The blood is against you. And the Lord, in a vision, showed me, don't you do that. The blood covers you from the second death. Come on, somebody, which is hell. Talk to me, somebody. The blood is to save you from sin. But when you back up a devil, say, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Somebody right now say, Satan! Rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You can run clean spirit. That subtle serpent. Rebuke. rebuke you in Jesus' name. Yes. Hallelujah. I'm going to close the service. Stand in the room. Here we go.
Oh, hallelujah.
Jesus. We're exposing an unclean spirit. Yes. That's what we're doing here this morning. Jesus. And don't, thank you, Lord. Don't you let the devil let you shut out this word here today. That's a subtle spirit. I said that's a subtle spirit that lets you reject truth. It's a subtle spirit that lets you shut out what your spirit is telling you. Receive, receive, receive. Don't let your flesh speak louder than your spirit. Let the desires of your flesh speak more than how your spirit is speaking. Lord, teach me how to yield to the Spirit. Teach me how to yield to your Spirit. Yield, yeah, yield. You know, it's a lack of yielding to the Spirit that causes many not to receive the Holy Ghost. Because a subtle spirit fills your mind. A subtle spirit overtakes your mind. In moments. Have you ever been in a moment when you want a breakthrough and all of a sudden your mind is filled? It's a subtle spirit. In that moment, that's when you must rise up and say, Satan, I rebuke you.
Hallelujah.
Right now, everybody lay hands on your head right now. Command right now by the authority given to you by God. Command that subtle spirit. Rebuke the devil right now. Rebuke that enemy right now. Your trouble is not greater than your God. Your problems that you're facing is not greater than God. The thoughts in your mind is not greater than your God. Rebuke the devil and he shall flee. Rebuke that subtle spirit. That spirit that tells me I can't live for God. I rebuke you. That spirit that tells me I won't make it another day. I rebuke you. That spirit that tells me my marriage is not going to work. I rebuke you. That spirit that tells me my children are going to fail. I rebuke you. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. That spirit that's been attacking my mind, attacking the way I think, has pushed away pure thought. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus Christ. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power. Spoken in tongues. Run down to this altar. You're in this room right now. You've never received the baptism of the Holy Ghost speaking in tongues. As you're walking, begin to declare, it is mine in Jesus' name. Come on.
Flesh church, come on, body.
go behind and help him.